All right, guys, I have started recording. So, as I was saying that in this course, we are going to learn manual testing, Oracle database. We are going to learn automation. Automation, we'll learn two tools in automation. One is an open source tool. Another one is a licensed product. So, first of all, that licensed product that we are going to learn, like normally medium to big organization who has a lot of money, they use that license tool. So for that tool, if they want to use it, every year they will have to purchase license, and each of the license cost $9,000 to $10,000 only for license. So that is unified functional testing. That tool was previously owned by HP. Now they sold it to Micro Focus. So that is HP UFT. The previous name is QTP, Quick Test Professional. And now they named it to Micro Focus Unified Functional Testing. So that is a license tool. If an organization want to use it, they will have to purchase the license, and license cost a lot of money. So we will learn that tool. Not that much. We'll be learning like so that you can face interview. But our primary goal is an open source tool. Okay, what is open source tool, right? Open source tool is this tool is like you do not have to purchase any license. It is free. So with free tool, like lot of small organization, lot of small to medium level organization, they use this tool. Even some big organization, many big organization where they have a skilled resource, they use it. So it is open source, but here the programming language is Java. So the Java language is a little bit complicated than VB scripting that we use in UFT. So this Java language, to use this Selenium, right? It needs Java language, and you will need to understand Java language a little bit. Not that deep, but you will have to understand Java language. Now, this Java language, if you understand this Java computer language, then it will be very comfortable for you to use that, what is it called, Selenium. So Java is the core thing behind Selenium, okay? So all of these things we are going to take care of our classes that we are going to have in the next few months. Now, at this point, right, I will have to give you this introduction on this software testing, like that is we are calling manual testing. I'll have to make sure that you understand these concepts, you are able to explain it, and you have full confidence on these different techniques in manual testing. Plus, our database learning will be going on parallelly. Every week, you will get a list of homework from me. It will not be that much, but few homeworks you will get it. If you can submit it, let's say, before Friday, so that I can use Friday and Saturday to evaluate them and to give you feedback. So you the homeworks, list of homeworks you will get, your target will be to return this homework by Thursday. Okay, so Friday and Saturday I'll be using to give you feedback, and on Sunday we'll have class. Now, this class, nothing like very scientific will be discussed here. Throughout this class, nothing will be overcomplicated, and I can tell you that some of the thing will not be so simple. Okay, so two things in this course, nothing will be so much scientific, rocket science, or overcomplicated. No, nothing will be overcomplicated. And besides that, I can tell you, few of the things that you will be going through here will not be super simple. Okay, so it will be like some of the topics you might have to struggle. You might have to struggle. Few topics. So what do you do if you cannot do something, right? You try. You try to, like, when I was in university, right, few of the, like, I was a computer engineering student, right, so we had to study math from first semester to the last semester. We had a lot of mathematics. So few of the mathematics, like, it was overcomplicated. So to pass the exam, what we did, we got some technique. Okay, that is how I need to answer it. And I passed it. So this mathematics, I'm not using in my work or day-to-day life, but I had to go through. So in this course as well, few of the things, right? Few of the things that will be coming and will not be super simple. And I'll be explaining it multiple times, but you'll have to give adequate time on this. And remember that when I was a student, right, we didn't have that much like of opportunity to go to internet, to go to YouTube. We didn't have that much opportunity. We had to go to library, and in the library, like, we have to see if that particular book is available, and we have to, like, if I go to a library here, I can bring as many books as I need to home. But over there, one or two books, and it was hard to get books as well. But at this point of time, right, this QA topics, whatever we are going to learn here, there are so many help in the internet. If you just type something in Google, you will get so many explanations. There are so many tutorials in YouTube, right? People from around the world, they are creating videos and they are helping people, okay? So there are so many ways to learn things. And for all of you, right, who is here to build a career in computer science and engineering, right? So after this course, like, you will have to be in a job. That is your goal. Even during this course, let me tell you this from my experience. Even in my day-to-day work, I do not remember anything. Few of the things I'm doing every day, it works. But a lot of the thing, okay, what is the syntax of this? I go to Google, type it, and I take it from there. Right? So Google, using Google smartly, I know that all of you are using Google for all sort of thing, but using Google for this learning thing, for different terms, QA terms, to see the term from different perspective, you will get a lot of help from there. Okay, all right. So we have all of our folks here. So the discussion that we did last week, right, on software development, how it works, right? Who wants to explain your understanding a little bit? Who wants to share it with the class so that we know your understanding? That is what you have learned from that last class. Will you come forward? Any of you? Naved, can you hear me?
I can.
So that software development, right? How that flow goes, how that life cycle goes in an organization. If you can explain in your language, it will not have to be standard English. Just whatever you have understood.
So the software development life cycle is called SDLC, software development life cycle, and it basically starts with the requirement. Testing environment, it's a testing process. Once the testing process is done, then it's the release, so, and then this goes to the production. The release part, once the release part, they send to the release, they also, this goes to the like new user interface testing. Once this is done, everything is good, it goes to the production. So this process is software development lifecycle.
Got it. So here what you are saying that software development starts with requirement analysis and then everything, right? Everything, like if you want to buy a house, first you see like what is your necessity, right? So what is your capability? All of these things you analyze and then you buy the house. Same thing, software development life cycle, right? Software development life cycle. In a brief, we are saying SDLC, right? It starts with requirement analysis and then there are a few steps, design, coding, and then testing, and then release and maintenance, right? All of these phases going on. Now, remember that we have discussed another thing during our class. Okay, I was presenting a document where like IBM was the developer, Georgia State was the business, like how this flows goes. Like in terms of requirement gathering and then what like at what stage we the QA people get involved and then what we do. Can you explain that?
So let's say start with IBM, they have a software company, and IBM they want to make a software. So the client is Georgia State University, and so Georgia State University, they want to make a software, then they go to IBM and IBM start conversation with that, and then they come up with their requirement. So what they need basically for the what basically they want for what content they need for the software. So they start with the requirement and then they talk with the BA people, like the business analyst people, and then they move forward to the requirement. Once the requirement is done, it's go to the it's called FRD, functional requirement document, and it goes to the business analyst people, BA, and once it is done, it goes to the developer team. So developer team start writing code and design everything, and they send it to the testing environment. Tester people start testing, and once the testing is done, they send to the UAT environment, dev environment. The dev environment, they make sure is everything working as per the requirement, everything working, and then also the real user using the software, make sure it's working everything as far as the requirement document. When it's done, then it goes to the production, goes to back to the Georgia State University again. So the software is ready for use.
Okay, so you have explained from your perspective. Now, Aliza Babi, Amit, and Nipa, one of you, can you explain your understanding on this diagram that we have discussed during our last class?
Yes, I can try to.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So from my understanding, first, Georgia State takes their business to IBM, and they have a discussion with the business analyst, and the business analyst creates a document, I think it's called BRD, and then they send the document to
to these two groups of people, software developers and software QA group.
Once the dev environment development?
Let me correct you this. The software development group, right? Software developer, they develop the software in the dev environment. So a dev environment is a set of servers, computer servers, which developers use to develop the software. And then once a certain portion is developed, then they move this code to the QA environment, so that in the QA environment, QA people do their testing.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So then after they finish the testing, after the QA environment finish the testing, it goes to the pre-production where customers go through the software to see if everything is good, mm-hmm. and then it goes to the production.
It goes to the production. Okay. So, yeah, you explained it a little bit better. That's good. Then, so here, this, if you take a look, all of you, right? Let's say Georgia State is a business. They need a software. IBM is a big software development company, right? Georgia State need a software. They go to IBM. From IBM, right, there are few people that we are calling BA, business analyst. Remember, business analyst. Business analyst sits with Georgia State business people and collect the requirement of the software. And they prepare a document, which we are calling business requirement document, or BRD, business requirement document. And basically, it is a brief description of the requirement. And then from the BRD, they elaborate and they prepare a detailed detailed requirement document that we are calling functional requirement document. It is a detailed version of business requirement document. And also, these BA guys, they prepare use cases. We will learn what is use cases. It is most of graphical, okay? So they prepare. The BA talks to the business who needs software. Right, business needs software. BA from the software development company talks to business experts, and they collect the requirement. From the requirement, they prepare business requirement document, functional requirement document, use cases, right? And after that, BA, once they have prepared all of these documents, right? So business analyst, they prepare BRD, FRD, use cases, FRD and use cases, okay. So once these documents are prepared, this document goes to two types of people. One is who will be developing software, another one is the QA people who does the testing, okay. When software developers got that requirement, right, like a construction, house construction, right? When civil engineers get the requirement, they prepare a design and then they lay out the plan. So same thing, software developers, they prepare technical design document, and according to the design, they start writing code. And software QA people, what do? Software QA people, when they get this document, BRD, FRD, use cases, right? They start laying out their testing plan. So they analyze the requirement, and based on the testing need, they prepare their test plan and they write test cases. Remember, test cases, you will hear this word a lot, test cases. So they prepare test plan, and they, from each of the testing need, they create test case. And after the code deployment, remember this word, code deployment. So when the developers are done with the development or certain portion of the development, they hand it over to the QA people. Hey, we have done developing these many features. Can you start testing? So QA people, they do testing. They do testing, and when they do testing, QA people, they do not do testing based on what they have learned at their home, or based on whatever instinct they have in their mind. No, they do the testing according to the requirement. According to this requirement document, they have prepared test cases, and based on this test cases, they do testing. Now, while testing, if they see something is not matching with the requirement, right? While testing, if QA people see that if something is not matching with the requirement, they report bug or defect. Remember this word, bug or defect. So if you work as a QA, you will be writing a lot of bug, right? You will be writing a lot of test cases, okay? You will be writing a lot of bug. So what is that bug? So this bug is not tiger, okay? This bug is like in a glitch in the software, a defect in the software. How do you identify this defect? You identify this defect by matching the software with the requirement. If you see that whatever is required, it is not working in the required way, then you report bug or defect. We'll be learning, we'll be reporting defect as a part of this course as well. So this bug, they write the bug and then assign it to the developer. And then the developer, they analyze the defect or bug, and if it's a real defect, they fix it and then return it to you. Hey, we have fixed your defect, can you retest? Now, you might be asking a question, guys. If that developer, if he knows it is fixed, then why he has to ask me? Right? Why he will be sending it back to me, and why he will be asking me? If he know he has fixed it, he can close it and that's all, right? Do not you have this question? Guys?
One more time, so
what I'm... So he is creating the product. When he is creating according to the requirement, right? And then after creating the product, when there is a defect, you are testing it, and then you got a defect, and then you are reporting the defect, and then when he got the defect, now he is fixing it. But after fixing, he is going to reassign it to you. Hey, I fixed the defect, can you retest? Now, question here, why he need to ask you?
So are they not able to test the product they made?
Yeah, so this is the question. So see here, why they have to ask you? Why not they test it and send it to the production? So here is the thing, right? Remember that, as I said in the previous class, we will be learning Java and some languages, and the developers always they will be working with Java and other languages. They are like the amount of technology they know is better than what we know, because their task is to develop software, and it is always they will have to write complicated logic, okay? But still, the software they develop, we have to find defect in their software. We have to find defect in their code. Those guys are, in terms of logic, in terms of understanding the matter, they might be in a better shape than us. Because I saw that testing folks are not that much technical. We are technical, but not all of the folks are that much technical. Few of the folks are very plain, right? But still, they will be testing the software that is developed by a very skilled person on their field. On their field, they are very skilled. So what is the catch here? Remember that this one, right? When a doctor gets sick, right, he goes to another doctor. Every doctor will have their own doctor. They do not prescribe medicine probably to themselves. Okay, now this, like these developers, whoever is developing the software, right? They are like when they are sending this product to us for testing, they have already tested this product many times. Remember, I develop software, and before I'm happy on this development, simple thing I do. Design it in a different way, and then I deploy it, and how does it, I change, no, it doesn't look like with the requirement. So a lot of thing we do, but after doing a lot of thing, then it comes to us. But still, we get a lot of defect in their development. Why? Because developers normally will not get defect in their product, because whatever they have developed, it is, to their knowledge, it is the best. When it came to you, it is the best. It is what is like the good thing they have developed, but they will not see the defect. So who will see the defect? Defect, like you as a tester, you will see, okay, this is my requirement. I do not know how he developed it, right? I need to, like, I will be inputting the user ID and password. I will be click on login. I want to see the bank statement. That's it, right? You go it in that way. You go from the functional perspective, okay? So that is where, like, it goes. So there was, like, I was talking to a person a few days ago, and then he works as a contractor in a financial organization. So there are a few folks from Asian subcontinent. So there were a few folks working from there. And so his understanding was some of his... in his organization, some people are saying that if we pay that much here for a tester, with half of the money, we can hire a very good developer there. Offshore, we can hire a very good developer with half or one third of the money. So why we are paying that much money here to the testers, right? So the legitimate answer for this is, the development works will be done by developers. Testing work will be done by testers. If you want to do get a, both of this job done by developers who will be doing the developing and also testers, the software will not be defect free. There will be a lot of defect. That is why in USA, every organization, right, from small to big, everywhere there are QA people. There are software testing people everywhere, not only in here, all over the world. There are QA people all over the world. And
just quick question. I heard that the developer, they make a one software, like, so once they build the software, the software itself starts testing their own software.
So self-testing software, it is again you will have to write automation code to do that. So if you want to test the software, right, you will have to write automation code. The only way to test automatically is the automation. Automation using like any of the automation tools, right? So that is, again, as I said, it can be written by testers, it can be written by skilled people, but everywhere from Bangladesh to everywhere, there are IT organizations, there are QA people. Even I saw that in our country, QA people are getting better salary, and they are skilled. To get a skilled QA is difficult in some places. So Naveda, was I able to answer your question?
Yes, but I had to make a own software, like the software
I didn't hear that. And then all of our QA folks will not get job. It is, yeah, I didn't hear that, and it is basically the need of tester. It cannot be. I know that a lot of places there are automation going on in the car industry. Instead of putting a people who will be, you know, adding parts to the car, they are putting robot. But again, there will have to be something, right? In the car industry, there are a lot of robot. They are deploying robot instead of human being. The robot is now building the cars, but still there are robots there. But in software, right? In software, let me tell you this. In software, that robot is run by a software, right? That software will have to be tested first before that robot goes to build the car, right? That robot will have to be tested many times so that things are done accurately. Everything, whatever automation tool is coming into the market in terms of, let's say, automating car, in terms of different thing, right? Automating everything. There are now in the supermarket, during nighttime, there are few supermarkets who does the shelving using robot, right? So all of these things will have to be tested before they go for product work, right? Productivity work, they will have to be tested so many times, so many phases. So everything that you are talking, let's say a software will be testing the software. I didn't hear anything about it. If there is anything, that will have to be tested many times as well. Okay. So now this, why these developers, they are developing the software, fixing the defect, and why I have to test it? Because that is how it goes in software industry everywhere. That is how it goes. So once this this software here is bug free, so the developers, they develop the software in dev environment, and then they there are few people, they move the code from dev environment to QA environment, where QA people do the testing. And once the software is defect free, right, it goes for UAT or pre-production environment, right, where user acceptance testing happens, where people from business, right, people who came here for software, right, from Georgia State, they come and test this product. And also, in this pre-production, the software is tested with high volume for performance to see, like, if many people access this product, if it will be able to handle the load, and then the software go to production. All right. So here, BA prepares BRDFRD use cases on the requirements from the business owner or stakeholder, sends the documents to the development and QA team. Right. Development team prepares their technical design document and starts writing code to develop the functionalities. QA group, in the meantime, prepares the test plan and write test cases, right? Developers write the code in the development environment. So note this, this is a note, that developers write the code in development environment. Who can tell me what is development environment? What we have explained from our last class. Amit, are you there? Can you hear me, Amit? Okay. So, Aliza Babi, are you there? Go ahead, Aliza Babi. I'll be coming to your question soon. So, like we have discussed development environment, Babi, can you explain a little bit about development environment? Oh, okay, sure, Bobby. That's fine. So development environment about Nipa, you want to say something about development environment? Okay, so when you write the bug or defect, right, the tool that you are using, over there is an option, okay, who you are assigning it to. You can, in some organization you will know, okay, this is a developer, I'm going to assign this bug to this developer. You will get a drop down, like if you have to select month from a list, you will select a month. So the tool that you will be using to report defect, on that tool you will be able to select a developer. Sometimes in some organization you will have a central person, you will be assigning all of the defect to him or her, and he or she will be assigning it to a particular developer. It depends, but most of the times you will be able to get a list who you want to assign this defect, and you will be able to assign it. You will know, like, who is the responsible developer for this particular portion. In a software there are many portions, so not all of the portions are developed by a single developer. Depending on if the software is a smaller, you might have one or two developer, but if the software is big, you might have many developers. So you will know by working with people, you will know who is responsible for what part of the application, and you assign this defect to that particular person. So to start a job, right, to start a job, wherever you get a job, you start. I started with a small company as an intern, and then from there I went to a contracting firm, right? They placed me in Wells Fargo, but they were a small firm. I was working there as a permanent, but they placed me in Wells Fargo Bank. And from there, I went to a bigger place like Regions Bank as a permanent employee. So it depends. Initially, you might be starting with a smaller to medium company, and then gradually you might be working for a bigger company where you'll get better opportunities. It doesn't matter wherever you are able to manage a job, right? Let's say if you can manage even an internship in software QA, that will pave your path for the remaining of your career. Getting into is very important. Okay, Naved. Okay, Nipa, were I able to answer your question?
Yeah, you did. Actually, one more thing.
Argument, no. In the software industry, the argument, like, it's not that way, but sometimes I saw in some places, if you're defect, the developers might say, oh, this is not a defect, right? This is not a defect. Then you will have to provide a screenshot and detailed proof that, yeah, this you'll have to say in this part of the requirement section 2, according to that requirement, you have to build it in that particular way, but you didn't build it. So you'll have to show proof, right, that it is a defect. And all of you, do you know how to take a screenshot? In a software testing, if you work as a software tester, you'll have to do lot of screenshot. So how do you take a screenshot, right? Can you see, like, if you type here snipping tool, right? Can you see this snipping tool? You take it, and then whatever you want to take a screenshot, Let's say that you want to take a screenshot of this part, right? And then if you want to highlight anything, you highlight it, or you circle it, or if you want to do highlight, you highlight it, right? You can do whatever you like. And then we as a tester, we do a lot of defect reporting, and we highlight things. Okay, this is where you need to correct it. If you need to erase anything here, you can erase it. Right. So all of these things, just be familiar with this snipping tool. Okay. I remember that when I started working, right, when I went to San Francisco to work for Wells Fargo Bank, I was writing code and a lot of things, but I was not able to take a screenshot like this. I was taking a screenshot in another way. So you will see that in your keyboard, right, there is a key called print screen. On top of the keyboard, you will see there is a key called print screen, right? If you click on that print screen, then it will take a screenshot. Print screen, if you click on there, it will take, sometimes you will have to press like function print screen. And then I was putting that one in a paint, right? I was going to paint and place it. So when you go to paint, right, and then if you right click, or let's say file, no. So here you will be able to control V, paste. If you paste, can you see that I have taken the screenshot by clicking on print screen? So I was taking a screenshot in that way, but there is an easy way. Whatever you need to take a screenshot, you go there. So one of the, like I was working with, so when I get job in another bank, Regions Bank, then my work was taken over by another Indian lady. So what was happening? So I go there to work there, and I work few months, and then it was pretty far for me. And then I got a job here in Birmingham in Regions Bank, permanent job. And then they were kind of mad, then where are you living? Or guys, can you hear me? Guys, can you hear me? Guys, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Sorry, I got a disconnected due to internet connection. All right, so so the thing that I was telling, even I was not able to take the screenshot on that time, and then the lady who was taking over from me, she showed me how to take a screenshot. So like taking a screenshot by using this snipping tool, I was meaning that, that in your testing, you will be using this, like let's say that you are having difficulties on something, right? You are not understanding or something is not working for you, and then you'll be sending a screenshot to me that, hey, this is not working, can you take a look? So you'll be taking this snipping tool, and then you will be taking screenshot like this, and then if you have to point anything, right, and then you point it out, this part is not working for me, can you take a look, right? So that's how you take a screenshot. So now, regarding, Sharmin, are you in the call? Sharmin, can you hear me?
I am sorry, I can hear you.
Okay, okay. So the document that we have discussed, right, like software development, the business people come to software development team, and then from the software development team, business analysts, they prepared the requirements, and these requirements go to the testing team and development team. Have you understood these topics? Yeah, there, Sharmin?
I did, yeah, I do have to review that a couple of times, but it does make sense, especially from the videos that you've sent me.
Mm-hmm. Got it. And regarding, were you able to install Oracle in your laptop?
I was able to do it this morning.
Mm-hmm.
I was able to switch it. I was able to do Windows OS on my Mac.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't downloaded it yet, but it's on.
Oh, the Windows operating system is now in your Mac, right? So you can log in. Is it in a virtual box or?
Virtual box.
And now we'll have a break for 30 minutes or so. On that time, see if you can install that Oracle in your Windows laptop. You can start the download, and then you can start the installation.
Okay, so I do have to sign up?
Yeah, you just create an account with your email address and put a password, and then you'll be able to download it. And then during the installation, it will ask you, put a password, you put manager as a password, yeah, administrative password. All right, so now this, let's come to this discussion. Elizabeth or everyone, do you have any kind of question to me so far?
No question.
Okay, all right, very good. Let's see. Amit seems 6 minutes ago. He seems say something and he went away. Let me add him. So now we have heard about this requirement, right? We have heard about this requirement, like BA people, they write the requirement and then they send it to us and the developers. Let's take a look at a requirement document. Let's take a look a little bit on a requirement document, and then after looking at the requirement document, we will go for a break, and after the break, when we are coming back, we will be starting the other part of the discussion. Okay, so my expectation from our this discussion will be, for the next class, you have a very clear understanding on this document. You will be reading this software development, you will be reading this software development process, right? It is not a official process, but that is what will make you, give you the overall concept, like how the software development goes. You will be reading this these few things here. You will be reading them a couple of times, and if you have any question, you will be coming up with question. This document, all of you have these documents. You will be reading it few times, and you will be coming up with question. If you do not have question, I'll be asking you question based on this document, okay, for the next class. Now, let's take a look a little bit on a requirement document that BA, business analyst, they prepares, okay? So, let me go back to my... Oh, you have a, like, for this class, are you planning to use Mac or Windows?
Yeah, I was actually planning to use my Mac.
So the problem here, like, these Mac computers, most of the time I saw that they have 4 GB of RAM. And this 4 GB of RAM, if you create a virtual box there, you have to share 2 GB with that virtual box, and sometimes it is difficult to operate both of the system. Like, let's say if you want to open Microsoft Word or any other program, it will give you real hard time. It will be, you'll have to wait for a long time. So that's why for this course, if you have a Windows laptop, that will be more convenient. And on that Windows laptop, we can install so many things. It will be more convenient to do this course. If you have a Mac, if you have 8 GB of RAM in that Mac, then you can allocate 4 GB for that virtual operating system, right? But if you have 4 GB of RAM, then it becomes complicated to operate different softwares that you will have to use for this course. So I'll say that if you have, so where do you have your Oracle installed at this point? So, like, see, like, what is your RAM in your Mac, and over there, you'll have to create a virtual operating system. And inside the virtual operating system, you will have to install those things. Now, how do you install virtual operating system? I have a video that I'll be sending it to you. Okay, so you will just be installing the virtual operating system. On that video, I have installed UFT as well, but you do not have to install UFT at this point. You just create the virtual box, install the operating system, and then over there you install the Oracle. Okay, and I'll say that if you can, for this course, if you can go through this course from a Windows machine, that will be more convenient for everyone. All right. Yeah. So now, so guys, so we now know that there is a document that business analyst they prepares, and this document goes to a set of people, QA people and development people. Development people create their design, create their software according to the requirement. QA people, they write the test plan, they write the test cases, and they do testing according to the document. So QA people, when they do the testing, they follow the test cases. Guys, follow this. When QA people do the testing, right, they do the testing by following the test cases. They write the test cases. Now, they do not directly follow the requirement document. Let me tell you this. QA people do not directly follow the requirement document. They do the testing according to the, what is called, their test case. Now, when they do the testing according to the test case, now how they are following this requirement document? Can anyone answer this? No, what I'm saying, Naved, when we do testing, we follow the test cases, those we have written. We do not follow this requirement document. But this requirement documents is the base of the testing. So how we are doing testing, we have written test cases, and based on the test cases we do testing. Now how we are saying that we follow this requirement document? We have written our test cases from the requirement document. We have analyzed the requirement document. We have read the requirement document, and to test this requirement, we have written test cases. You got it? Now, let me show you a brief. I'm going to have detailed discussion on this requirement document and test cases, but let me show you a brief of this requirement document. This is a brief requirement for a test software, right? It will have a page saying like what is that document about and who has written it, what is that about, when it was written, and then you will have a table of content saying okay, what we are going to, like there will be an introduction section and overall section, right? There will be different things, and then if you take a look here, right? In the beginning, they will say the purpose of this document and then few other theories. The core part here, right? It will say like who this document is written for, and then it will say that what is that project about, what we are going to do in this project. Just when you do a software development project, right, if you have a requirement document, it might be in a different format, but kind of, if you have to prepare a requirement document, if you prepare it in that way, that will work. So it will say what is that project about, what we are going to do in this project, and then product perspective, it will say a little bit background about this product. The key thing here, guys, remember that you will have to write test cases for in this course, right? To write test cases, you will be using these requirements. Can you see there are product features? These are the features, those will have to be developed and those you will have to test. So it is saying that there will be a home page that would be based on the Mercury application, right? Home flights, there will be different menu here. So these are the product features, right? These are the product features, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 product features. This is a test application. This is the brief requirement document. From that one, the business analyst will prepare a detailed, let me show you this application as well. So if you go there, right, if you go to new tools, demo AUT, new tools, demo AUT, right? So that the requirement that we are displaying here, right, this requirement is for this application. Can you see this home flights, hotel menu, right? Login. So if you look at this requirement document, let me bring it. This one, this is the requirement. Based on that requirement, that, can you see home flights, hotel, car rentals? All of this menu is described here in this requirement, and based on that, this application is built, this one. Now you will do some automation by using Selenium on this and other application. So here, if you take a look, right, this requirement, it says like what they will have to develop, right? Now, so for you, what you are going to do is by using this requirement, I will ask you write some test cases. So as a testing professional, you will be reading the requirement document and you will be writing test case, right? Now, when you write test case, what is your baseline? Your baseline is the requirement documents. So I'll give you a sample requirement documents and few other sample requirement documents from where you will be writing your test cases, you will be automating them, and also you'll be reporting defect. Now, if you take a look here, I'll be showing you a few test cases as well, so that you can you see, like as I said, that you will have to write a lot of our, as a tester, we test the application according to the test case. And where do you Go ahead.
Is this section recording?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, we are recording. So what we do, we write test cases from the requirement document, right? We read the requirement document, and to test this requirement, we write test cases. Now let me bring a sample test case. So as a tester, you will be writing lot of test case. Now how this test cases or test case look like? Can you see? This is a very simple test case. Yahoo Mail search foundation, search function, right? So it will, a test case will have a step ID, step description, expected result, actual output, pass fail remarks. And depending on what organization you work, there could be many other columns, test data, dependency, a lot of other columns. I'm just showing a plain test case today. Let's say step ID and then step description, right? Open browser and navigate to yahoo.mail.yahoo.com. Expected result Yahoo logo will be appeared on the top left corner, right? So let's say if you go there in this page, if you go there, what do you see? Mail.yahoo.com. Yahoo logo will be appeared in on the top left corner. Can you see this? So when you write a step, basically you say what do you expect. It could be a logo, it could be many other things. Normally we say a very visible thing, and if that visible thing is there, we expect that the page will be loaded. And then input email ID to text box and click next. So password text box will be appeared, right? So if you go there, if you input a email ID here and click next, then what do you see? It will give you a password option, or however way it works, right? So can you see, like, what is test case? Step by step way of testing the application. You input an email ID and password text box will be displayed, and then input password and click sign in. Inbox, you will be able to see the inbox, right? And then on top of inbox, you will see you can search email. You write an email address and you can search it. So that was the feature. If you type it, corresponding emails will be displayed, right? That is, like, we will have a lot of discussion about test case. So I was trying to show you today, that is how the requirement document looks like. And from the requirement documents, we will read the requirement documents, and to test different functionalities, that is how we are going to test different. We will write test case. So far, do you have any question? Let me see who I have. Okay. Nabet, so far, do you want to ask any question? Okay, so that's good. And then, Nipa, do you have any question?
No way, I'm good.
Okay. Aliza Babi?
Can you please repeat that again? I'm lost, actually.
No problem, Babi. If you take a look here, that business requirement document, right? This business requirement document, BA writes the requirement document. And then they send this document to us, right? We read the requirement document, and from this requirement to test this requirement, right? Then we write test cases. Each of the requirement, you will be reading each of the requirement, and each of the requirement to test it, you will be writing steps. So these steps are plain English language. So what are these steps? Let's say if you are testing Yahoo, right? Yahoo Mail. So what will you do? Open browser and go to mail.yahoo.com. And then when you go to mail.yahoo.com, you have an expectation. You are saying, okay, make sure that you are seeing this thing. and then input email ID to text box and click next, right? So, when you do that, you will be able to see password text box or something else. So you say a activity and then you have an expectation. And when you test, if you do not get the expectation, then you write here, no, actually we didn't get it. We didn't get it, we get something else. This is a different thing, but how we write test cases? We write test cases, we provide a step, and then each of the steps has an expectation, right? So that is how, from the requirement document, we write test case. So if I say, hey, Bobby, can you do this? Can you write a test case? Can you write a test case to test the login functionality of this application, right? Of this application. So what will you do? You'll go there and then you will be creating here. So you'll go there and then you will be creating a table here. Insert table and then insert table. How many rows? Let's say we are going to put 4 rows. And how many, 4 columns, how many columns? Let's say 6 columns. Okay, 6 rows, 4 columns, okay? So, if you take a look here, the first one we are saying, ID, step ID, right? And then we are saying step description. And then we are saying expected output, right? So here, first of all, you have to open the application, right? Navigate to, what is the name of this application? Navigate to this application. Navigate to this application, right? Once you navigate, what do you see? You see that Mercury Tours logo, right? Can you see this? So what do? You write here that once you navigate to this website, on the top left corner, right? Mercury Tours logo will display, okay? And then the test case name, right? Let me put a little bit name here. Test case name, let's say Mercury Tours login, okay? Then, so if you want to test the login, then you'll have to input the user ID, right? So according to the step, you will say number 2, input user ID. So when you input a user ID here, let's say automate code. So user ID, we can see that user ID is there in the text box, right? So that is what we are saying, input user ID in the user ID text box. So what is the expectation? This user ID will be displayed there in the text box. Then you put password. So input user ID, and then input password in the password text box. So when you input password in the password text box, let's say I'm putting a sample password here, then password will be disc password will be displayed, but it will be encrypted. Can you see this? It is not showing the password. This is a business requirement. So you will say that password will be displayed as encrypted. Every password, it will have to be encrypted. Otherwise, the application is, there is an issue with the application. And then the last step, after inputting the password, you click on sign in. So if your password is good, it will take you to the home page. If your password is not good, it will say, okay, password is not good, or it will take you this page. So you say that if you input a good password, so you say click on login. After you have input user ID and password, click on login, and then it will take you to the home page. So input user ID and password and then click login, home page will be displayed. So what is the summary here? Summary is, when you test an application according to the requirement, you will have to provide a step, and when you provide the step, what is your expectation from this step? When you are inputting user ID, what is your expectation? So that is what we are calling test case. Is it clear, Bhavi?
Yes.
So we will, like this test case and requirement, we will have probably 2-3 classes. I was just showing the, okay, that is how it looks like, right? That is how, you know, this test case look like. It is not like we are having a detailed discussion. We will have further discussion. So at this point, guys, are we ready to take the break? And come back at 11:35. Good.
Okay, Bhaiya.
We'll come back at 11:35 to continue our discussion. So in the meantime, if you have to install anything, if you have to take breakfast, please go ahead, and we'll start again at 11:35. Thank you. Bye. Darababa.